We're going to start out with just a very simple loop drawing. I'm going to make some big, gentle lines and create some shapes and spaces that are large. And I want to end where I started. And if I do it right, I don't know, I'll have like 14 or 15 spots, even one little tiny one. Don't go wild. You just want to stick to a few shapes. If you do too many, you're going to have a lot of work ahead of you. Now you're going to fill your spaces with patterns by using markers, which I know will get people excited because you've been wanting to use markers. I start out by just outlining my whole thing so it's easier to see. Then I'm going to go into each one of my unusual shapes and start to make a pattern. I'm going to start out with geometric shape, and I want to keep that pattern up and fill in the whole space. I'll move on to a new shape, and I'll come up with another pattern. I like switching colors between shapes. So many patterns that you already know that you may not realize. I can use thick and thin lines in the same shape to make a unique pattern. I love making little dots, but I don't want to smash the point of my marker. Be very respectful of that. Don't bop it down on the table. Just gently touch it along as you go. Be gentle with the markers. I even got the idea that I could do my initials as a pattern. But I am starting to run low on ideas, and I've got a couple of spaces left. I got some inspiration from what my friends were doing, and I even repeated one of my patterns. And now my design is finished, and I'm ready for next week when we will turn this pattern design into a three-dimensional sculpture.
Hmph.